Get ready to match the stars from Lou Grant, Daryl Anderson, Rick Summers, Charles Nelson Reddick, from Angie, Donna Pescow, from Florida Country, Richard Paul, and Patti Deutsch, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Rayburn.
Okay, John, shall we go at it here? All ready?
Sure.
You look rather gloomy.
Thank you. I'm excited. This is the big stuff now.
That's right. Yeah. She's won the $100.
Yeah.
And now she's going to play for 10 times that amount or $1,000. However, we've got to spin this thing around here and lower the big star wheel. And you're going to spin it one more time. Oh. Now, last time you did it, you did very well with it. And now let's see if you can do it again. Good luck to you, my dear.
Go, baby.
There we go. Let's see if she gets a double. Instead of $1,000, that means you'll be playing for double the money or $2,000 with Daryl Anderson. You ready, Daryl?
Yeah.
All right. She's not nervous. There's no reason for you to be nervous, is there? Now, good luck to you, my dear. Here it is. On this card, it says, blank fair. F-A-R-E. F-A-R-E. Blank fair. Blank fair. Blank fair. You come up with your answers very quick. No, you had it just like that, didn't you?
What did you say? What? You didn't say F-A-R-E.
I said F-A-R-E.
Oh.
I spelled it 9 times.
Twice.
Twice you spelled it.
She was talking to you, and so you didn't hear me spell it, did you?
Yes, I wasn't talking to him. I was conferring.
Leave him alone. I said F-A-R-E, dummy.
I heard him say F-A-R-E. That's why I was conferring with him. I said, he said F-A-R-E.
This is it. This is the real one. This is the one. I'm turning it up. I'm putting it in there. That's it.
All right.
It's over.
Now, you give us the answer that Daryl has in the card. We give it 2,000 bucks. What do you say?
Bus.
Bus fare. Okay. Daryl, she says bus fare will match you for $2,000.
An interesting answer. It's the answer that. I love this show.
You got $7,550 now. Do your little dance for us. This little message for you here while she's doing her little dance. Go! Here we are. Let's all welcome Wayne Babin. Hey, Wayne. Now, want to get acquainted with you before we start?
Fine.
What do you want to tell us about yourself?
Well, I'm originally from Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
Mm-hmm.
Few Southerners around, I guess.
Right.
Moved here from Mississippi, where I was a college professor. If I keep going on states, I'll get them all.
Yeah.
I'm a research coordinator here with a group that checks on quality care of people with kidney disease and kidney failures. And I have 3 children, ages 15 to 19.
Mm-hmm.
And that's about it.
Now, what did you teach when you were in college?
I taught exercise physiology and kinesiology.
Oh, would you like to hit me in the stomach?
Well, now.
Sir, you don't meet many kinesiologists.
No, sir.
You must know my friend Larry Morehouse, the kinesiologist at UCLA.
Dr. Morehouse, yes.
Yes, indeed. He's quite a guy.
Yes.
You kinesiologists are very interesting people now. But pay attention to what Wayne says here today. You may learn something. Okay, Wayne, you can have A or B.
How about B?
B, right. Here we go. The prison guard said, that convict is weird. Take a look. Take a look already. It's the first time I ever saw anybody try to blank in the electric chair. Okay. All right, wait. Now, this is a round one question, so, you know, whatever comes to your head. The prison guard said, that convict is weird. Now, take a look. It's the first time I ever saw anybody try to blank in the electric chair.
Tinkle.
When in doubt,
That'd be smart. That'd yeah. be, and that's short-circuited.
He could short-circuit it, that's right. And it wouldn't work.
Bad.
Well, my answer kind of sounds similar. I said whistle.
Whistle, yes. Whistle a happy tune.
What did you say he was?
He's a kinesiologist.
That has something to do with the kidneys, doesn't
no.
it? Did I?
Kinesiology concerns itself with the study of the movement of bones and muscles and how they move and interact and all that.
That's the answer.
Yes.
Kinesiology.
Right.
Right.
So how come a man like that says tinkle?
What?
I said sleep.
Sleep. No one has come up with a definitive answer. Maybe Charles has it.
Well, I'm sick of these attacks.
Yes?
I said read a newspaper with pipe and slippers and a sizzling dog at his feet.
Not around to hear that answer.
You know how fast a wire-haired terrier can go up under those conditions?
What have you got for the kinesiologist here?
Get a shave and a haircut.
Get a shave and a haircut. Now there's an imaginative answer also. Yes?
Then we come to me.
Right.
I was asking Patti if it was a strange answer, and then I realized who I was asking. So.
Yeah.
Tap dance.
Tap dance. It's the first time I ever saw anybody try to tap dance in the electric chair.
Actually, I think they probably do, don't they?
Yes.
Yeah. Order room service.
Order room service. It's funny, you know what they thought would come up?
No.
Rock. Pretend it's a rocking chair.
I thought of that.
I would think that would be a natural
play. Tap dance. Yeah.
Never entered my mind.
Did you think of it, Wayne?
No, I sure didn't.
Bad question.
Okay.
Terrible.
Wayne thought of tinkle.
All right. Linda. You ready for yours?
Yeah.
All right, this is it. Did you hear that Marshall Dillon had to leave town?
Oh, no. What happened?
In a hurry?
Was there a comma there? Tell the truth.
He found out that Kitty had a blank.
Oh, he took my answer.
I did not. I didn't see your answer, and they can check it on the tape that my head never looked that way, and you can make an appointment with the production office and look at it, and may God forgive you.
Thank you, Reverend Riley. Linda, did you hear that Marshall Dillon had to leave town in a hurry? He found out that Kitty had a blank.
Baby.
A baby. Do you think he was responsible? Really? Uh-huh. I suspected those two. Yeah.
I said Kitty had a kitten or baby.
She had a baby kitten.
Charles and I don't want trouble with the judges, do we, darling? We have to...
Don't talk to me, dear.
Kitty had a litter.
Kitty litter.
No, a litter of kittens.
Kitty had a litter. Litter kitty.
Kittens.
Yes. Litter.
Litter.
Yeah. All right. Well,
now I'm really mad.
Yeah. Kitty litter.
Now, wait. Kitty,
what?
If Kitty is her name.
Yeah.
And not her.
Her name was Kitty.
Person.
From Kansas City. Yeah. Da 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 da.
Look how it gets so weird all of a sudden.
Yeah.
If Kitty was her name, then she's a person. And if she had a litter, then she had a baby.
Isn't that interesting? You know she got the buzz.
I know, but I thought it was a couple of minutes of airtime. Close up.
Okay.
Well, the reason why I left town was that she did have a baby, and it was born with spurs on.
Uh-huh. Okay.
I said litter, and it wasn't his.
Litter, and it wasn't his. So, it's 2-0 at the end of round one. Round two. Round two coming up right now. Yeah. Okay. Well, we got a round two here, Wayne. Again, you have a choice of A or B.
I did so well with B last time, I think I'll try it again.
All right. Here it is. Ugly Edna said.
Yeah.
Ugly Edna said, I'm never going back to that insulting doctor. After he examined me, he told me that it looked like my blank had the mumps. Never going back to that insulting doctor. After he examined me, he told me that it looked like my blank had the mumps.
Oh, I hate himself.
Ugly Edna said, I'm never going back to that insulting doctor. After he examined me, he told me that it looked like my blank had the mumps.
Derriere.
Derriere, he said. Okay. They're applauding derrieres out there, Daryl.
Well, you see, I'm not applauding. See, my rule of thumb for this is that if I'm stuck, I just say boobs.
Oh, I can't. What in doubt? Right.
You know my scientific method?
Yeah.
Very heavy into science, I was.
Yeah.
I came up with boobs instead of buns.
You threw away buns.
Threw away buns for boobs.
Okay.
Jeepers crow, criminy Dutch, golly gee, good gravy. Anyway.
Pathetic. Buns.
Buns. There's one match for Wayne.
I couldn't
decide. He's looking for a pair of buns.
Yeah, oh, really? I couldn't decide between boobs and buns, so I said body. I just...
The whole body. Right.
The whole...
Couldn't make a decision, eh?
No.
Did you make a decision, Richard?
Yes, and I think this just might be a match. Exactement.
Yes, exactly. If Patti Deutsch makes it three.
No, I said upper frontals.
Upper frontals? Okay. Now, again, Linda, you're in a catbird seat. All you need to do is match one to win another game. Fred said, this weather is really terrible. It's so cold. During the night, my goldfish built a blank. That's how cold it is.
What?
You don't play.
Charles isn't ready.
Fred said, this weather is really terrible. It's so cold during the night, my goldfish built a blank.
A house?
A house.
A house?
Goldfish built a house? What would you say, audience? Yes.
I play.
Oh, you do play. Oh, yes.
Don't walk past me.
I was going to walk right by you.
A igloo.
I was going to say water closet for an obvious laugh.
Right.
But I said fire.
Fire is very good. Fire and igloo, two good responses so far. Linda's looking for a house. Fire, another fire there. By Jove, Patti, this game could end in a tie unless you say house.
No, I said campfire.
Campfire. So we do have a tie, 2-2. And we'll tell you what happens with the tie right now. We'll turn off these lights here, eradicate the score, and go to the tie-breaking question, one for each. The one who scored the most will be the winner. Wayne, A or B?
B, please.
Okay. Nerdocrumbesia.
Nerdocrumbesia?
Is the world's cheapest country. Before a sporting event, they play the national anthem on a blank. Cheap country. Okay, Wayne. Nerdocrumbesia is the world's cheapest country. Before a sporting event, they play the national anthem on a...
on a stereo.
Couldn't think. Stereo. You see, his expertise, his field of expertise are bones and muscles, not brains. A normal country, like in America, you hear the Star Spangled, they hire a big, expensive singer, or they have a big band, or the Marine Corps, or the Vienna Boy, or the, you know. But in a cheap country, what would they do, Daryl?
They don't play it on a stereo. They come on, they play it on a kazoo!
Kazoo! See, you can buy them for a nickel. Or at least you could when I was a kid, but I suppose you can't do it anymore.
You can't?
No.
I guess I better cancel the reservations then. Is it a juice harp or is it a Jew's harp?
It's a juice harp, yeah.
A juice harp. That's a comb and a piece of toilet paper?
It's a little thing made out of metal. It makes funny noise.
You mean I've got a lifetime thinking it was a comb with a piece of toilet paper?
No, that's something else. Yeah. That's a comb with a piece of toilet tissue wrapped around it.
That's what I said, a comb with a piece of tissue wrapped around it.
Oh, yes, it's that. Aren't you glad you came, Donna?
Oh, yeah, you don't know. Kazoo.
Hey, Kazoo, the definitive answer. Richard.
The lonely wail of a harmonica.
Harmonica, another good one. I'm getting cheap little instrument. It'll be terrific here.
A nose harp.
A nose harp. That's it again. Okay, we're going to do a little commercial here now, and we'll come back to you and see if you break the tie of 0-0. Gene River. Okay, Danielle, thank you. Now, Linda. Again, you're in a good position to win, as you were last time. Just have to do is match one, and you will have won your third game. Ralph said, I just saw the world's biggest worm in my backyard. It was so big, it had a blank in its mouth. So big, it had a blank in its mouth. Have you got an answer? Okay. Ralph said, I just saw the world's biggest worm in my backyard. It was so big it had a blank in its mouth.
A bird?
A bird? Well, yeah, that there's some logic to that. It would be the opposite idea. You usually see a robin in your yard with a worm in its mouth, and this time there would be a robin with a hello there.
See, I get all sunny every time I get a match.
Pleasure to meet you, and we're going to send some gifts your way, some nifty things that you'll be able to use, and I hope will come in handy. Wayne Babbitt, ladies and gentlemen. Goodbye, Professor. Again, Linda wins her third game. She now has $7,650, and let's see if she'll win a lot more here. She could win a big bundle here. We polled the studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Eye of blank. $500 for matching the most popular answer, for matching the second most popular, $250. And then if you team up with the third on the bottom there, you get $100. Three of the six stars
exactly
will give you some help.
Is that right?
Richard.
Well, if you were into witchcraft, you would need the Eye of Newt.
Eye of Newt.
Brett. Well, if it was raining and you was driving, you'd go right into the eye of the storm. Yep.
The eye of the storm.
Donna.
Oh, I was so afraid you would.
Wait a week, hon. We got nothing. You know me. I'm never alone. Here's the best one.
I'm having a message from my mentor. Eye of needle.
Eye of needle.
The needle.
Eye of the needle. Yes, that's a new dish they're fixing. Eye of needle. Okay, you got eye of needle, eye of the storm, eye of newt. Those are the three. What do you want?
I'll go with eye of newt.
Eye of newt. You know where that's from?
Sure don't.
You don't?
No.
You never heard of that phrase? You remember the witches in Shakespeare's witches?
Toe of frog.
Yeah. I'll tell you about it later. Come to my dressing room. I'll explain. I'll read a little Shakespeare to you. And let's see what we've got here. We'll go down there at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. See if we got Eye of Newt. No, we have Eye of an Eagle.
If I had the eyes of an eagle,
over these prison walls I would fly.
Thank you.
No. All right. Looking for Eye of Newt. May we see the $250 number? Eye of the Tiger.
What does that mean?
What?
We'll
I don't
never
know.
Get
what,
eye of
what, is eye, what does that eye of tiger mean?
Veterinarians.
What? Tigers have good eyesight? You get out of here. You don't know.
Who are these people?
Where did you get them?
Birds have keen eyesight. All right. Eye of Newt. Is it under the big one? Please, go.
Fun at me. You poked fun at me. Twice you poked fun.
I poked fun at you.
Once for me.
Yeah. You're right, once in 6 years. I figure it's safe to poke fun at you all the time. Well, that surprised me, so you didn't get it. And Linda, you're going to meet another player later. Right now, we're going to do a little business with America. Here it is. How much time we got here, Ira? No time. Oh, well, then I better go and say goodbye to you and hope you'll join us next time for Match Game 79. I'm Gene Rayburn.